Good afternoon, everybody. As you all are aware, the WHO has declared this week as the week for World Awareness Antimicrobial Awareness Week. So we will talk on rational prescribing of antifungals, which is very important to minimize antifungal resistance in our country. As you all know, fungi are eukaryotic organisms with cell walls and they are heterotrophs. Most of these fungi are multicellular organisms, but these are unicellular organisms. Epidemiology of fungi: these fungal infections are killing more than 1.5 million people and affecting more than 1 million people annually. And these fungal infections are most neglected topic by the public health authorities. And most deaths from fungal diseases are avoidable deaths. And most fungal infections are hidden infections occurring as a consequence of other health problems such as asthma, AIDS, cancer, organ transplantation, etc., etc. And to diagnose these infections, it needs specialized testing, and delays or misdiagnosis often can lead to death, as well as serious chronic illnesses or blindness. Global antifungal resistance is a public health threat, and existing antifungal drugs has their own toxic side effects. And there are only very few new antifungal drugs under development. Fungal infections frequently complicate other illnesses. The classic example is mucormycosis or black fungus and invasive aspergillosis during COVID-19 pandemic. Prevalence of drug-resistant fungal infections increasing and exacerbating the already difficult treatment situations. There are treatability issues, toxicity, and underlying infections such as HIV. And multi-drug resistant Candida auris infections are widespread, and increasing resistance to commonly using antifungal drugs and emerging resistance to newer antifungal drugs as well, leading more difficult to treat fungal infections, and treatment failures are common, longer hospital stays, much more expensive diagnostic and treatment options. Fungi's commensal flora are there in the skin, vagina, and in gut from oral cavity to anus. And these are Candida species. Candida species become pathogens when the host resistant to immunity is lowered locally or systemically. And Candida species can cause disease in every location, especially superficial, locally invasive or disseminated infections. And it is the leading cause for invasive fungal infections in critically ill adult and neonatal patients in ICUs, and second cause of invasive fungal infections in severely immunocompromised patients. Candida species that are opportunistic human pathogens. These are Candida albicans, Glabrata, Tropicalis, Paraxylosis, Brucei, Guillemondii, and Fermata. All these can cause endogenous infections. So if you use antifungal drugs irrationally, these commensal flora can create resistance to antifungal drugs, and these endogenous organisms can cause endogenous infections after some time with the resistant bugs. Commonly known fungal infections in Sri Lanka: Tinea infections, Carrion, Snail infections, Pitrisis versicolans, Vulvodynia candidiasis. All these are superficial or mucosal infections. Fungemia, invasive aspergillosis, Cryptococcal meningitis, other invasive fungal infections, and Histoplasmosis are systemic infections. And locally invasive infections such as eye and sinus infections, pneumocystoma, chromoblastomycosis, conidiogonomycosis, pneumocystis, gyrosiae pneumonia, rhinosporidiosis, and UTI. Commonly used antifungal drugs in Sri Lanka, there are two types, systemic preparations and topical preparations. Under systemic preparation, there are voriconazole, itraconazole, echinocandins, and amphotericin B, which are red light antifungal drugs, which can only authorized by a hospital microbiologist. So please don't use these drugs unnecessarily, because they have made as red light antifungal drugs, because these are the drugs which can cause resistance very easily in the commensal flora inside the body. So please keep it in mind not to use these drugs and not to sell these drugs without the microbiologist's opinion. Current local situation, drug-resistant TENIA infections, multi-drug-resistant yeast infections, both local and invasive infections, multi-drug-resistant mold infections, and Candida auris infections. Common wrong practices which lead to drug-resistant fungal infections. Treating commensal Candida species in sputum or bile cultures. These culture-positive Candida species are oral commensals. So if you treat these patients with systemic antifungal drugs, this can only cause or create resistant bugs inside the body and can cause endogenous infections later on. Treating Candida species which has colonized urinary catheters. It is said that urinary catheters are colonized by Candida species within 20 minutes of insertion of the catheter. So if you really want to know whether the patient is having a UTI in a catheter inserted patients, what you have to do is insert a new catheter and within 20 minutes of insertion of the catheter, collect the sample for urine culture. Treating TENIA infections with steroids combined with antifungal treatment. As we all know, treating with steroids for infections can mask the signs and symptoms and also it can aggravate the infection. So this is same for the TENIA infections as well. So please don't use steroids, especially topical steroids, combined with antifungal treatment for these TENIA infections. What you have to do is refer the patient to a dermatologist because these resistant TENIA infections needs oral antifungal therapy. Treating Candida species colonizing the chronic wounds and molds colonizing the chronic wounds. So these Candida species can be skin commensals and these molds can be environmental contaminants. So if you treat these patients, you will be treating either the colonizers or environmental contaminants with highly toxic antifungal drugs. So what you have to do is, if you need to know whether the wound is due to a fungi, what you have to do is clean the wound with sterile normal saline thoroughly and then take a deep biopsy. Either a dermatologist or a surgeon can do this and put the sample in a sterile screw cap container with sterile normal saline and transport it to the laboratory at room temperature. So then you can do the mycological testing and get to know whether the causative agent is a fungus or not. Treating culture reports without direct microscopy test result. Direct microscopy is the test that we use to detect or to identify whether the cultured organism is a pathogen or a common environmental contaminant. So if you get the culture report without direct microscopy test report, please don't use that report to treat your patient because you will be treating a patient for a, it could be an environmental contaminant and you will be treating the patient with highly toxic antifungal drugs. Treating culture reports for Candida species with AFSD. Now, if a laboratory reports antifungal sensitivity testing report, that laboratory should first identify the causative Candida species such as Candida albicans, tropicalis, etc., etc. If they haven't identified the causative agent as Candida species, they cannot report antifungal sensitivity testing report. So because of that, please don't use this report to treat your patients. Treating superficial fungal infections without mycological diagnosis. This is very dangerous because the causative agent may not be a fungus. So always perform a fungal investigation before start treating your patients with highly toxic antifungal drugs. Using red light antifungals unnecessary is the main thing that has created antifungal resistance in Sri Lanka as well as globally. So please don't use antifungals unnecessarily. Let the microbiologists handle the red light antifungal drugs. Thank you.